The movie God's Not Dead was a box office smash. The film had a $2 million budget, and it made more than $60 million. Well, one of the stars of the show is with us today. Take a look.
Kevin Sorbo is an American-born actor best known for his lead role in Hercules, The Legendary Journeys. He played the muscle-bound demigod in that hit TV series that ran for 6 seasons. At the time, it became one of the highest-rated syndicated television programs in the world. Sorbo also played the lead in the fantasy film Call the Conqueror and starred in Gene Roddenberry's TV series Andromeda. Most recently, he appeared in the movie God's Not Dead.
And the movie God's Not Dead is now available on DVD in case you didn't make it to the theaters. We'll tell you more about that later. But please now welcome to the 700 Club actor Kevin Sorbo. Kevin, so great to meet
you. It's good to be here. Finally, I made it here.
Well,
it's good.
I'm a little starstruck, so bear with me. All right. Well, the movie did so incredibly well. Yeah. $2 million to make it, yeah. Make $62 million at the theaters. Why do you think it did so well?
You know, I think we've reached a tipping point in America. I think people are just, they're just sort of fed up with the number of projects coming out of Hollywood that don't reflect their values and their faith, their morals, whatever it may be. God's Not Dead was really word of mouth, seriously, because PureFlix does an amazing job with these movies. They're the largest distributor of family and faith-based movies. They've been in the business a long time. This is my 5th movie with them, by the way.
Oh, wow.
And the first one I did was called What If. People can check out What If, please do. It's on Netflix right now.
Okay.
And I think just, you know, it was strong word of mouth, because you have a $2 million movie to get in 780 screens is huge in itself, but because it finished in the top 2 in per screen average, it bumped it to 1,400, did it again, they bumped it to 2,000 screens.
Amazing.
It stayed out there for 3.5 months, and it was really because of people wanting to see movies like this.
Well, you play a very convincing atheist, a pretty mean guy in this movie, and we've got a clip from God's okay. Not Dead of Kevin playing this mean atheist. Let's take a look.
Do you think you're smarter than me, Wheaton? Do you think there's any argument you can make that I won't have an answer for?
I never said I was smarter.
That's the first intelligent thing you've said. I want to make this clear. In that classroom, there is a God, and yet, I'm him. I'm also a jealous God, so do not try to humiliate me in front of my students. You know, I also checked up on your declared major one, pre-law. What exactly is pre-law? We don't award degrees in that. Don't bother answering. But know this. If you truly feel a need to continue with this charade, I will make it my personal mission to destroy any hope of a law degree in your future. Have a nice day.
Did you say God bless to him right at the end?
No, I said have a nice day.
Oh, have a nice day.
I should have actually God bless would have been pretty funny. But no.
That was one of the most chilling scenes in the entire movie.
Yeah.
I mean, you were really seriously evil in that scene. And, of course, you're a believer. You love
yes,
God.
I am.
You know, but what attracted you to this part, Kevin?
Well, number one, I got to give kudos back to PureFlix. They do wonderful, amazing work. And they sent me the script knowing they said, look, this is going to create a little bit of controversy. It might be difficult for you to even want to play this part. I read the script. I was in right away. I've got atheist friends. We've had debates and parted as friends. But I also, I've seen these atheists on television, on cable outlets, and they're so angry.
Hmm.
And part of me, I feel pity for them. And on the other half, I laugh at it. I go, how can you be so angry about something you don't believe in?
Exactly.
And why do we give such a large voice to them? I mean, they pull down nativity scenes because say it offends them. Once again, how can something you don't believe in offend it?
Mm-hmm.
And you're offending 90% of this country by pulling these nativity scenes down. 90% of the country used to have the majority voice in this country. We don't have that anymore. We're losing our freedom of speech.
So you're making way too much sense right now.
Common sense is something that the country, half the country, doesn't want to deal with anymore. They hate the truth. And facts and truth are very disturbing to some people.
Well, Kevin, the truth is you've been a believer since you were 13 years old. Tell us, how did that happen?
Well, I've been a really believer my whole life. I grew up in Minnesota. I grew up in a Lutheran church. I'm non-denominational now. I go to church. It's just anybody who's a Christian.
Sure.
It's called God Speak. And I've always been a believer. But I was 13, and I saw Billy Graham speak at a crusade in St. Paul. And it was a hot August night. And yeah. I just remember it was an amazing experience for me. I walked up front with a friend of mine to meet with one of the volunteers, talked and prayed, and it's a moment that has been very indelible to my life and has just stuck with me all these years.
You know, so many people have gotten saved through Billy Graham Ministries and or watching the 700 Club. Those two.
Oh, there's no question.
It's just really amazing. Well, you were promoting your, of course, most people know you from Hercules.
Yes.
Which is was an amazing
series.
Not a
bad thing. It was
not a bad thing at all.
There I just played a half god, so I was a demigod, but.
Right, right. Well, there you are.
There's my wife, actually.
We met
on the set. Yeah.
And her name is Sam.
Sam, yes.
And I was reading in the background information that the first scene you had with her, you were so nervous you forgot your lines.
I didn't. I never forget my lines. I hate to say never because, I mean, yeah. I've forgotten lines, but I'm very good at knowing. I come prepared. It's part of my deal. And I was blown away right away. I was smitten completely.
Well, I can see why you forgot your lines. She is absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah, she has her own radio show.
Really?
Yes. From 6 to 9 in the morning, Pacific Standard Time, the Sam Sorbo Radio Show. Check it out. She's number 12 in the country right now. And there's my family.
Awesome.
That was a couple years ago.
I'm
looking at the little mohawk my oldest wanted there. But he's almost 13 now. He doesn't like that he did that to himself now.
They are adorable.
They're great kids.
Well, things haven't always been as picture perfect for you. You were out promoting your first movie when you noticed something was happening to your arm, to your shoulder.
Yeah. It was into season 5 in Hercules, and I was coming back to do some promotional work on Call the Conqueror, and I was about to start my second action movie for Universal. We're going to shoot in Atlanta. Problems with my left shoulder, couldn't figure out what was going on, saw a doctor. Before they found out what it was, it ended up being an aneurysm in my left subclavicle that completely opened up. It sent hundreds of clots in this arm, but 3 clots unfortunately went to my brain. I suffered 3 strokes.
3 strokes.
And obviously I could have been killed instantly. I could have been in a wheelchair the rest of my life. The 3 bullets to the brain, so to speak, 2 went to my balance center, 1 went to my vision. I still have a 10% loss in both eyes. Spent the next 4 months learning how to balance and walk again. It took me 3 full years to recover to feel whatever you could say 100% would be after suffering 3 strokes.
Wow.
I was very fortunate. I have a book out now called True Strength, and I've been doing a lot of speaking engagements on it. And it's really a motivational book. It's a triumph over tragedy, but there's a lot of humor. It's not a downer, and it's been amazing on this journey with these speaking engagements. I've had people come up to me that were car crash survivors, stroke survivors, heart attack, whatever it might be, saying the book has motivated them to stop feeling sorry for themselves, because really the book is about not setting limitations for yourself when something happens to you, because we're all going to hit that wall one day.
Sure.
We just don't know what that wall is going to bring.
Isn't it the irony of being Hercules and then having this major, almost debilitating injury?
It was tough to go from a guy that was playing the strongest man in the world to somebody who couldn't even stand up and walk. It was emotionally, psychologically, physically, it was a long battle for me.
Do they know what caused it? Was it working out too hard?
They have no idea. They said it could have been something from birth, some biological thing. Could have been all the years of lifting weights. I've been lifting weights very heavy since I was 15.
Sure.
And at the time, I was about 230 pounds, and I was pretty ripped up on Hercules. And, they don't know. That could have been a combination of stress that I don't know if I was feeling stress. I didn't know because I was loving. I was 14 hours a day and then 2 hours a day lifting weights afterwards. So a typical day, 18 hours door to door wasn't unheard of. But I was living it.
Recovery.
I know what things still I can't do, but I passed every physical exam they can throw at me. So
and you're back in the gym.
I was back in the gym. Well, it took me about a year to get back into working out again, but I'm back in the gym.
Well, back to your marriage. You've been married since 1997, 3 children.
Yeah.
1997, that's a long time to be married in Hollywood.
1998.
Okay.
Well, we met in 96, got married a year and a half later.
You know, how do you make that work?
16 years. I told my wife in Hollywood, that's like a silver anniversary. You know, I was supposed to have 4 wives after 16 years. But you know what? Certainly our faith has a big, plays a big part in it. Our relationship is just, we homeschool the kids. I think that's important. We decided to do that about 4 years ago because I travel so much. I've shot about 40 independent movies over the last 9 years.
Oh my goodness.
But we have a new TV series we're pitching right now, so we'll see what happens. It's in the faith-based world, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah, I'm just going to ask you if you have any faith-based movies in the works right now.
Well, I have one done called Revelation Road, which will be out in DVD. It's part 3 of a series from PureFlix, same company I did. I've got a couple more that we're looking at to shoot hopefully down the road. I've got a family comedy coming out in theaters in November from Howie Klausner. Howie's most well known for Space Cowboys, James Garner, the late James Garner, Clint Eastwood, and Tommy Lee Jones. And that'll be out in theaters. Please check it out, called The Secret Handshake.
And I loved your role in Soul Surfer as well.
Oh, thank you.
Great movie. There's so many. Well, as I said earlier, the movie God's Not Dead is now on DVD. I encourage you to go pick up a copy wherever DVDs are sold. You're going to watch it again and again. I've seen it twice already. You want to see it again. Kevin, it's such an honor. God bless you.
Thank you so much. God bless you as well.
Thank you so much for being
here. My pleasure.